Greetings, you people. Hello, my king. How is it going? How has it been? This is Brian Stone. I do indeed welcome you back to some more Fallout New Vegas with Giorgio Bonet. We're about to carry on where we left off, and that is right in front of this manor house in Nipton. What crazy things have happened in Nipton? Well, Eddie Ed. Anyway, somebody could tell you. I may as well be one of the people who can tell you. See these tires burning? Well, that means the Legion, the Kassar, had come through her, and he had done some things and put people on trees, and now we're going to go inside this here building, and we're going to loot it. Yeah, let's loot the building. Why not, man? That sounds like a great idea. Everybody's dead already. Look at that. Everybody's dead. That is unfortunate. I'm not going to lie. That's sad. Wasteland Wonder outfit, whatever. This person has a backpack. How much does that sell for? I will take it! Though I do not know the way. Wasteland Settler outfit. Doesn't weigh that much. I'll keep it. Large burned book, destroyed book. He who destroys a good book destroys reason itself. I love that quote. Search wasteland. Hey, look, biker goggles. I'll take it. You know why? Because I can repair my own goggles. Let's look at my items then. In my items, I also have these biker goggles, which are the ones I'm wearing. I'm going to repair those with these biker goggles. So maybe I got rid of that crack in my head. Look, it's gone. Yes, there is no crack in the glass now. No. I have an idea. I'm good with explosives, right? I can pick it up. Did you see that then? Oh, take Nipton's basement key. What happens to be in the basement, I wonder? Don't know. Edie, move. Edie, thank you. It's really sad that everybody died in here, though. I mean, I'm really put out. Ball cap with glasses. Settler outfit. I don't need any of that extra stuff. Wait, ball cap with glasses. That means that I can not repair this, because I really don't have anything to repair it with then. Okay, fine. What do I hear? Caution. Danger. What? What? What is it? Ah! No! A Legion mongrel. Alright, well. That was excellent. I mean, I really don't want to kill doggies, but damn. I'm over here, pup. Do you see me? Look, I'm here. Wow, are you blind? Deaf? Right then. Legion Mongrel got shot by Eddie. Edie? Eddie Ed? Ed, Ed, and Eddie? Right. There's more here. Can I hit you? I can, in fact. Whammo! That is disturbing. Excuse me. That is a mighty punch I have. A mighty punch. Legion Mongrel. Dog meat. Dog hide. You know what? I'll take it. Because waste not, want not. In the Mojave, as they say. Also, I'm wondering if these dogs were the ones that killed all these people. Probably were. And they're rabid and crazy, which means that putting them down is one of the best things I could do. Also, they were trying to kill me. So putting them down is indeed one of the best things that I could do. Okay. Shouldn't have to justify that. That's funny, though, the head rolly thing. Alright. Maybe I'm just sadistic and weird. Not even maybe. I am sadistic and weird. Continuing to scavenge the area. Was this a school then? This looks like a school. That's not very nice. Wastelander prospector outfit. Is that a toy car? I'll take it. I don't know why, but I'll take it. I now have a vroom vroom. I used to vroom vroom when I was a kid. Right, you have these little toy cars and vroom vroom in the floor. Vroom vrooming in the floor when you're a kid takes on a different connotation than vroom vrooming in the floor when you're an adult. Very, very different. Open desk. Let's take a look. Let's check a look. Bottle caps. Excellent. Then you might remember Thomas of the last episode. I'm starting to feel bad about that. Starting to. There we go. Proper pronunciation. Starting to feel bad about killing him completely the way I did. Thinking that maybe he was lying to me. But he wasn't lying to me. Did you trip? You died running from the dogs. You didn't die from the dogs. You died running from the dogs. You come through this door and leap like a gazelle over these chairs. And then fall on your face and died. I have to say, that is probably the saddest thing ever. Ooh, biker goggles. I'll take that. three cheers for trying. So there's gonna be that, and biker goggles. Is it now? It's completely repaired. I have a brand new pair of goggles. I'm so happy right now. Oh, man. This is where the town meetings were held, apparently. Oh, hi then. Stop it with your meanness! Right. Take all that then. There's a dog in here by himself, having a meeting with himself, apparently. Chairs here, chairs there, there's a guy here, on the floor, dead. He has another leather backpack, I will take it. And, do the leather backpacks take damage? Because if they do, well, the condition is actually pretty good. No, it's just a leather backpack. No, they're fine, they're all fine, in fact. Right, okay. Everything's great.
Everything's awesome.
So I am about to go where? Upstairs, of course. Duh. Wait, what happened? So, you knocked the dog's head off while it knocked your leg off. Am I understanding this correctly? Dog meat times three. Nice. I'll make myself some dog steaks. So let's open this door to the assembly floor. Assembly floor? For the assembly of what exactly? Holy Jeebus! What is happening? Why am I hurt? Where are they then? Oh, hello! Where are they coming from? There you go, Edie, get him! Eat him! Get him, Edie! There you go. Edie, Ed. Legion Mongrel. Take that. Take that. And I leveled up! Alright, now then, let's go for... Boom Booms. To 50! Not to 50! You know what I'm talking about, right? The not to 50? Come on. Google it! In quotations, not to 50! Come on. You'll figure it out. If you don't know it, you will. Anyway, welcome to level 5. I had to put them all into that. I had 10 to give away, and I put 10 in explosives. Seems legitimate. Seems legitimate. I like it. Also, that means that I can break open locks. If I'm not mistaken, I can break open locks that need a skill of 50 of explosive, for instance, to open. I don't know if that's how it works, but we're going to find out regardless. We're going to continue there. Drink to the last. A lady killer, swing for the fence, cannibal. Persistent manner. You have learned to stay frosty and wait for the right time to strike. This allows you to score more critical shots, and that's when you aim at an enemy who is reloading. Tech Chucky. Where's my pants? Heave-ho. All thrown weapons fly farther and faster for you. That would be kind of cool. I do a lot of throwing of dynamite, to be honest. Drink to the last. Only people who have almost died from thirst know how precious water is, regardless of where it is pumped from. With this perk, you can fill up any empty bottles from any toilet. That is disgusting. But it is kind of cool. I could go around and start collecting empty bottles, and well, to that end, I can also have a never-ending supply of water. Is that what I want to do? Tech junkie. The fun never ends. I can get more scrap metal from dead robots, which is kind of cool, not gonna lie. You woke up with bags of money and caps in the middle of nowhere without your pants. I don't know what that's about. I want to click it, but I don't know what it's about. Lady Killer, heave ho, drinks to the last, confirmed bachelor, intense training. I can put a single point into any of your special attributes. It's pretty interesting. I could add it to my agility and I'll be even faster. Maybe. With a swing to the fence perk, you will be able to deal slightly more damage with an unarmed or melee attack. You know what? I like it. We're gonna go for that. Swing for the fence. More damage, you damage. Feels good. Legion Mongrel, let's go ahead and grab that, grab that. I have to look out for landmines, apparently, because they set one off just a second ago. Is that an empty? Oh, it's an empty bottle. So, Wastelander, what do you have? Just a caravaneer outfit? Alright. Nothing else going on in here, apparently. So let's go around the way we came. What, this guy here has nothing. This mongrel does, though. He has hide and dog meat. Take some time to butcher it. Waste not, want not. Mentioned that before. Excuse me. Wastelander, you have nothing that I want except makeup. I mean, I have a bonnet. I look pretty. I don't even need makeup, though. That's right. You guys are right. I don't even need makeup. I'm too pretty. I'm already pretty. Don't have to be prettier. Dirty water. Purified water. Why do you have all this stuff? Fresh apple. I'll take it. Beer. You have all these things. Dead prospector. You fought up here all by yourself. Aw. I didn't get here in time. It's okay. That means I get a fresh apple. Let's have an apple then. Aid. Where's my food? I want an apple. Deliciousness was made real in my mouth. Wait, that's the way I came. Okay. So I've gone that way, which was a no way. I've gone that way, which was a no way. Do I just go upstairs now? We go upstairs again. Door to Town Hall Stain's office. Let's go take a look. Alright. Open door. Interesting. First aid box. Psycho Rad X and Rad Away. Sounds delicious. I might put that in me. Vending machine. Bottle cap. Sunset sarsaparilla. Open that vending machine. Nuka Cola. Perfect. Coffee machine. Refrigerator. What's inside then? Oh my god. Absinthe? Really? I'll take that, and junk food, and prickly pear fruit, and sunset sarsaparilla, and some dirty water. Alright, who puts dirty water in the fridge? It's like, this tastes disgusting. Let's keep it around a lot longer. Well, there we go, open this then. Oh, pre-war money! Finance clipboard, I don't know why I'm carrying it, but I have it. Now I'm going to write down my adventures on it. How much money have I cost people so far? Well, I cost them lives. The average life is worth a little over $1 million. It's like 1.1 million. The average life. Well, I could just blow that open with dynamite, I suppose. Edie, come back here, please. Come on, Edie. There you go. Get away from that door, because that's going to be dangerous in just a moment. Woo! Wait. Still hidden. Is it still locked? Of course it's still locked. Because I missed! Give me it, Edie. Get away from that door. Hoopa! There it is then. That's gonna work. Oh, I hurt Edie! I'm sorry, Edie, Edie, Edie! Open that door then. It's inside. Nothing so far. Open that desk. Ah, bottle caps. And we have another empty desk. Is it really empty? I don't know. I don't trust it. Tool cabinet. A knife, I'll take it. Filing cabinet. Carton of cigarettes. Clipboard, I'll take them. This one too. Ashtray and a pack of cigarettes, I'll take that. I'm starting to feel like a hoarder right now. I'm hoarding all the things. Open this door. Anything else in here? Then I could sit down for a second. Sit down for a spell, as it were. Finance clipboard. I'm done with the finances. Scrap electronics that seems appropriate. Laser pistol. Future weapons today. You know, I as somebody who really respects and loves Eddie Ed, laser pistol seems very interesting right now. Not that I'm going to use it, but it just seems interesting, so I'm going to pick it up and probably sell it. Book of Science. Mentats and Programmer's Digest. Whoa, okay, wait a second. There's a Book of Science. What do I do with that? Miscellaneous? No, it'd be data, right? Miscellaneous. Book of Science, anything in here? Nope, okay, nope, never mind. It'll be under Items and Aid, I suppose. Mag. Is there a Book of Science in here? It says Book of Science. Miscellaneous, then. Book of Science. Is it in here? No. In fact. Unless I'm just keep missing it. Why do I pick up the Book of Science if I don't actually have it? Local map, world map. Peril weapons. Is it a weapon? I mean, if it's a really big book, it might be. Nope, peril. Book of Science, Book of Science. There's nothing here. Okay, let's go slow. Big Book of Science, that's right there. Alright then, what do I do with that? Science increased by 3. Well, that's not bad. That's a permanent increase, I take it. I have taken a bullet to the head, but it doesn't mean that I can't read, apparently. And I read, and I am now smarter. Big Book of Science, written by Neil deGrasse Tyson. Alright, Programmer's Digest. Can I get into this computer? Reset mainframe connection, testing prison break. What is that all about? High roller. Let's look at that. I can hardly believe my luck. Literally, I'm agape. Just now, I was approached by a rather intense young man calling himself Mr. Vox. Yeah, right. When we were alone in my office, he let it be known that he is a member of Kaisar's Legion. He knew that NCR troops and powder gangers often spend time in Nipton. It turns out that the Legion hates and wishes to make an example of both groups. The NCR for obvious reasons and the powder gangers for harassing the Legion raiding parties on this side of the river. I didn't have to think a moment about Mr. Fox's proposition before accepting it. All I have to do is convince the powders to kidnap the NCR troops at night. When both groups are in town, the Legion boys will scoop everyone up. Ha! For this simple task, I have been offered 8,000 caps. Whoever this was sold out this city. I can almost go back to the NCR right away, but who knows how much else I might make off this Legion lackey. I'm going to start stockpiling some supplies in a safe house between here and the Mojave outpost, just in case I decide to head back home in a hurry. Very exciting. Signed with a steady hand on the keyboard. Sorry. Super Mayor Joseph B. Stein. Esquire. Uh-huh. Reset mainframe connection. What does that do? Handshaking complete. I have no idea what that means, but okay, then testing. Tony was kind enough to build this terminal and set it up for me. All for 30 caps worth of rosé. Ha. Huh. What's a rosé? A rosé. Is that a wine? Maybe he's talking about? Anyway, the life of a mayor suits me just fine. I'm glad I didn't go any further east. I'm making plenty of caps right here off Rosie and Sylvia, who attract plenty of interest from troops at the Mojave outpost. Guess you spend enough time standing around that black backwater, and you're ready to hop on something that looks like a mole rat and doesn't smell much better. And the local shops are all giving me a percentage of sales to the troops because it's my girls who bring them in, huh? They think they're shrewd negotiators for getting me to accept 15% cut instead of 20. Another year in this dump, two at the most, and it's back to the hub for me. Maybe I'll run for office there, ha. I don't like Stein very much. A promising development, if I do say so myself. It seems things went to hell at the NCR Correctional Facility north of here, and escaped prisoners are roaming free. Sounds like a bad thing, and would be, if not for the political acumen and interpersonal alchemy of yours truly, Mayor Joseph B. Stein, Esquire. I sent the gems out to make contact with the prisoners, or powder gangers, rather. They insist on this name. To let them know Nipton's open for trade, with free turns with the girls as door prizes. Ha, you know they went for that deal. So little Jim, anyway. Big Jim, rest in peace. I see a lot of potential here, so long as I can keep the NCR troops and Powder's ridiculous name from running into each other and shooting it out in the streets. Luckily, the troopers only come at night, double entente. So if the Powders will only come during the day, again, I'll have them coming third time, the charm, and going. Yours in confidence, Mayor Joseph B. Stein, Esquire. Right. That was very, very interesting. Locked average. Does that mean now that my, we're gonna find out right now, guys. We're gonna find out whether or not I can blow this door up with a 50 skill in dynamite. Woo! Kaboom! Does it work, then? Does it work? It does not work. Really? How do I open up a door with an average lock of 50? That's a really strong lock, my friend. I'm gonna hold that down. What do I have for dynamite? Nothing? I've only got a mine. Well, that's unfortunate. Just those two, really? Do I not have any more dynamite then? Weapons. I have to have dynamite. I have to. I have to have boom booms. I have a time bomb, at least. Maybe I have to put it on my slot item there. Binoculars. You know what? We'll put it where the binoculars are, because, well, like, why not? Oh, wait, no. That's what that is. Time bomb is a mine. Varmint rifle, shovel, machete. Frag mine. I am out of boom booms. I find this really disturbing. So now I can only throw spears, really? That's not explosive. But it's still ranged, and I suppose I'll take what I can get. Is that everything, then? Have I gone through all the places? I mean, I really want to get past this door here, but how do I? You know what I'm check out? 1 second. Let's go into here. Mod configuration. Is it rebalance? Or is it? No, it's core. Is it core? Settings. Features. Features? Explosive entry. Explosions can be used to break open locks. It just says they can be used to break open locks. What does that even mean, then? If you can't break open some locks. I don't know. If anybody has any idea how to get through a locked door of 50, please leave a comment in the comment section down below. And let me know if there's anything I can do about that. However, despite that, despite all that, I am now leaving. So let's go back downstairs. To the first hall, then. And we're gonna leave by way of the door. So that was a thing. Made my way through here, I suppose. Killed a bunch of animals. Don't exactly feel good about that. I never found Stein, unless Stein is up here somewhere. I don't think Stein is here anywhere, because if Stein was here, unless he's behind that door, right, I don't know, but didn't he say something about, south of here? You know what, I wonder if I can go find the bastard. That would be very interesting. Let me go read that note again. I'm gonna get rid of his filth if I can. Not to say that I'm much better, mind you, but I don't go selling girls, at least. I'm making jokes about it. Alright. Let's find this out then. Testing Brett High Roller. Is this the one? I missed it. Okay, so let's look at it again. I did it again! Ah! Right. What does it say? Take a moment about Mr. Fox's proposition. I'm going to start stockpiling some supplies in a safe house between here and the Mojave Outpost, just in case. Between here and the Mojave Outpost. Right. Okay. I think I can figure this out. we're gonna take a look. If it's quite simply in the middle, smack dab in the middle, I'll be able to figure it out. Wait, where am I? No, okay, I'm in the right place. It just seemed a little different for some reason. There we go, open up that door. And that is going to be the end of this video. If there's anything about this video that you did indeed enjoy, please leave a like and subscribe to the channel for more content such as this, and realize that Giorgio Bonet is going to actually go find, or at least try to find, this guy's hideout, as it were. And if we can find him there, bonus. If we don't, maybe we just, you know, stash, like loot all the things that might happen to be there. And with all that said, I'll see you next time. Have a good day, have a good evening, wherever you are in the world. This is Barrera Stone, signing out.